pass now to the numerical methods, and we focus on topology optimization. As general theory, topology comprehends all concepts that can be associated with criteria of space proximity and of convergence. In our field of application, topology of optimization is composed by mathematical models, and it starts from the simple idea that the optimal configuration can be found by removing unused material gradually from an initial material distribution. This briefly is an history of topology optimization that belongs mainly to the 20th century, beginning from the Mitchell's theory on the space truss, till the generalization and application of the last years. So, fundamental elements of topology optimization are the design variables that can be subdivided in dimension variables, shape variables, and topology variables. Just for example, think about a truss. The section of roads are dimension variables. The relative position of nodes are shape variables, and the typology of the roads are topology variables. The second element is the design space that has to be a discretized domain according to the use of FEM technique. The third element is the design objective that is a function or a functional subjective to boundary condition that have to be minimized or maximized. And the last one regards the design boundary condition like geometric conditions or displacement. Connected to the objective design, there is the problem of stationary local solution because in the most of case of use of optimization process, the solution found are stationary, but often they are local and not global. We think about this fact is not bad because the solution founded by optimization process is not the unique solution, but we can found a set of optimal solutions that can be used by the designer in the way of optimize other constraints like the architectonical constraints. The optimization process begin from the structural analysis and structural model and structural analysis, and it use optimization algorithm till the reach of the optimization model. In this work, we focus on two typology of algorithm, the classical mathematical algorithm and the genetic algorithm. The first one is a simple code found in a paper of Sigmund of 2001. The own features of this code are that the design domain has to be rectangular, the objective function is the compliance, and the relative density of elements are the variables. The optimization problem can be written as we can see and as already shown by Luca Frattari. And the result we obtain is one of like that. For each iteration in the loop of topological optimization, the code generates an image of the current density distribution. We can stop the algorithm at each step we can see in this figure. And this is another way to give to the designer different optimal solution in which he can choose the one he prefer. This second figure is an example obtained for an initial domain of 30 per 100 with the central concentrated load, and we can see an example of the same shape that can be recognized in a common typology of bridge. Pass now to the genetic algorithm. Genetic algorithms are population-based iterative algorithms that operate a set of solutions at every step, emulating the Darwinian evolution. pursuing a survival of the fittest strategy, where the fitting property are defined by the objective or fitness function. The operative steps of this algorithm are the sequent. First, we have to define a chromosome that describes every possible solution. Then the starting population of solution is generated by random process, and each individual is evaluated according to the fitness function. So each individual has its own fitness value. Then individuals with the best fitness value become parents, and the parents mating produces a new population of solution. Genetic algorithms are efficient algorithms, but they can also be improved hybridizing them with deterministic method. Just for example, we cite the hill climbing method that is the one that operates just one solution at each step, and this is the best individual found by the genetic algorithm, and it looks for a better solution in the neighbor, making a refinement of the solution. The problem posed in this work is to apply the genetic algorithm to a grid shell. The grid shell is 5x5 nodes composed by mutually clamped beams, and the corners are all grid to the all pinned to the ground, and it is subjected to concentrated loads at each node. So the optimization problem is to define the optimal nodal heights distribution in order to minimize the general level of momenta acting in the structure. And so we define the fitness function as the sum beam by beam of the resultant vectors of the triplet of momental vectors. I have a video, if it works, ecco, ok. In this video we can see the work of genetic algorithm and the solution found, as you can see also in the figure, is axial symmetric and is composed by 4 parabolic arches and 1 catenary in the middle of position. And these 5 structures are connected by 4 border arches on each side. This configuration is different from the one we expected, because we expected the classical dome configuration. We tried to give an explanation of this fact, and we verified also this fact with different FEM programs and with manual calculation. And the explanation is the sequence. The central pulling catenary arches decreases the secondary bending momenta acting in the border arches, lowering the pushing effect over other arches. This is not possible in the dome configuration, because in this configuration all the arches are pushing. In conclusion, we have done a walk in history and contemporary times to find some object in which shape and structure were kept together in design. We focus on structural optimization as different from usual design method, and we use topology optimization to have a complete vision of the relationship between architectural and structural design. Use these methods and this technique, we can refine the design process, and we can reach more efficient results, more material exploitation, and more security in the structure. Using words of Pierluigi Nervi, static sensibility and aesthetic sensibility will become closer and closer. And thank you so much.